The mesh mapping adjustment system has been developed to greatly improve the adhesion of the first layer of prints for BCN3D Epsilon series and Sigma series printers. During the printing process, the height of the printing platform is automatically adjusted, thus compensating for small undulations on the printing surface. The mesh mapping will register any irregularities on the printing surface, so it's very important to always place the glass in the same orientation. Before starting, make sure that the printing surface is correctly installed and centered, making sure that the calibration square ends on the backside. You can mark the top of the printing surface with an adhesive, bearing in mind that it must be marked outside of the printing area. Please note that mesh mapping is not compatible with mirror or duplication modes, and will be automatically disabled when printing with these modes. Before starting with the mesh mapping, we always recommend leveling the build plate by following the instructions on screen and adjusting the thumb screws. Then click Calibrate to start the proper mesh mapping process. First, use a piece of paper to clean the nozzle thoroughly. Your printer will now measure the printing surface in 9 different spots and map the height differences. Once the process is finished, the adjustment will be automatically activated and applied. You can enable or disable the mesh mapping function at any time and manually edit the values recorded at any point with the Edit Mesh option. You can also enable or disable the Fade option. This option will allow you to choose between having a piece with ripples or having the printer compensate for these ripples by adding more material so that the following layers are progressively flatter. Having Fade disabled will bring the print surface undulations through each layer of the whole part, which may be preferred based on your design intent and part tolerances, whereas enabling Fade will compensate for the undulations by adding more material so that the following layers are progressively flatter. We recommend keeping the fade enabled to avoid wear on the Z-axis motor due to the constant height adjustment that the motor would have to make throughout the printing process when the option is disabled. If you need your part to have the same height between its base and top layer, and you understand that both will have the undulations of tenths of millimeters from the printing surface, then you can disable this option.